In this session, I will talk more into how we can work with role and skill sets. First off, as many of you know, Team Planner is the tool where you can do demand on high level. That means you are requesting on a role level. That could be a developer, a project manager, a product manager, or something else. But we also see the need for doing skill sets and have the knowledge on which skills can you actually do as a developer or a project manager. In Team Planner, with the two new latest versions, we have allowed to work with skill sets on both request and allocation level. We have several options how to do that, which can actually mean that it can fit into any organization that wanna enable and work with skill sets. So as you know, we have generic resources, which is primarily on a role level, which could be a developer, project manager, product manager, or even a UX expert. As a requester, I'm not always sure what I need and from where I need it. Typically, this is why we have the high-level demand on role level. I need a developer. But in some cases, we see that you actually know more. Like, I need a .NET developer, or I need a developer that knows HTML or Java. This is where we can now work with skill sets. We can work with skill sets on the generic resources. How is this done? Well, first of all, we have the role and a generic resource. We know that this generic resource is associated as a developer. Then second, we can start adding attributes like skill sets. So we can say this specific generic resource is not only a developer, it's also a developer inside a team that is specialized in .NET or in C# or in Java, for example. This allows us to have the knowledge on where to put the request, not only for a role-specific generic resource, but also for the skill sets. So for example, I can go into Team Planner, and here I can go into my request picker, and then I can decide, all right, I need a developer. When I have chosen that I need a developer, I can say, okay, where in the organization do I actually need this developer from? Because we could have several departments or teams that are having developers. I can choose to say I want it open. I don't care where the developer comes from. Then next up, I'm allowed to choose from which skill sets this developer should actually be able to do or have. And as you can see here, I can choose between the different options that we have associated with the generic resource. That allows me to specify my search saying I need a Java developer or a HTML developer. And if we click on the HTML developer, it only shows me those developers in the organization that have the skill sets of HTML. With that knowledge, you can specify your search even more and ensure that your request goes to the correct line manager. This is very beneficial in large organizations. But if you didn't know it, you could also just leave it as it is and say, okay, I don't care about the skill set, show me all the developers. I will send the request and then the line manager will ensure that if it's correct, requested, he will allocate. He or she will allocate. If it's not, the line manager is able to forward the request to the right place in the organization. Secondly, we have another option which can help us. We have introduced contract properties. So this allows the project manager when doing the request to add more information. We can add different properties like seniority, skill sets, or other things like location. This will not help out the project manager filtering out on generic resources when doing the request, but it also means you don't need to ensure all your generic resources is associated with a skill set. This solution is simple and easy to get up and running, and it allows the project manager to say that, okay, I'm requesting a developer, then I'm adding the properties like seniority, could be a senior or junior. And then the skill set needs to be a HTML developer. And then it could be a specific location, like Denmark or Norway. This is done by enabling the contract properties, setting up the properties that I'm allowed to put in on a request. And then on a request level, you can go in and add the contract properties. So in this case, when I'm requesting a developer, go into contract properties, add the seniority, the skill set, and maybe also the location. This ensures when the line manager receives the request, he or she can go in and see what is needed for the project manager to fulfill this request. And here you get the information, and again the line manager can take the decision whether he or she has resources that actually fulfill that need. If not, they are once again able to forward the request. Solution one, with adding skill set to generic resources, is very beneficial for large organizations, but it also requires some more data maintaining on generic resources, because we need to associate the skill sets to all of the generic resources to ensure that it will actually work properly. Whereas the second solution is much more simple and easier to get up and running, but this doesn't allow for the project manager to narrow its search all the way into the skill set needed. It just allows for the project manager to say, I need this kind of skill set, but I don't know if I send it to the correct place in the organization. Thanks for watching. See you next time, where I will keep you posted with more updates from Team Planner and how to work the best way inside Team Planner.